Thank you, and I'm actually happy that you've made that introduction, and happy also to be speaking after Simon, because I think I'm in a good position to respond to both the arguments you have raised. One is that of capacity building, and that's exactly what I'm going to be speaking about, because I think Global Focus Center, together with the MFA and with UNDP, are actually doing just that as we speak, and we have started on the 1st of July. So I'm happy to be officially announcing that we are tackling this problem, and 1 year from now, this is not going to be a problem anymore. I promise this is going to be an opportunity. And then the reason we're doing it is starts from the very points that you've made, Simon, toward the end of your presentation, and I must say we sort of started from a negative assumption, and that assumption was that Romania was punching below its weight in foreign policy. Our think tank is essentially a strategy think tank. It's not development oriented necessarily. But when we started thinking, what should we address first? How can we contribute to Romania gaining in clarity and in efficiency in foreign policy? We said, well, we obviously have a lack of focus and a lack of foreign policy planning. And I'm sorry to be saying that with the distinguished MFA representative here. But we said, okay, where do we start? How can we as a think tank try to address that? And we assessed that since policy planning doesn't seem to be the strongest point that of Romanian authorities and think tanks at this point, what we do have and can build on is the lived experience of transition and democratization. It's since there wasn't enough investment, I think, in building the capacity of Romanian institutions to be more active and efficient in foreign policy, well, at least we had the benefit of having lived through certain extremely important processes that so many other states and parts of the world are going through right now. And we assumed that Romania had a number of benefits. We started much lower than many of our neighbors, so our transition, let's say, itinerary, the road to where we are right now, has been very thorny at times, very difficult. And so we can luckily share from a peer-to-peer basis, not patronizing, not being suspected of economic interests or other political interests, as middle powers usually do. We can share the experience of what to do, as Mrs. Anna Birchall was saying, and of what not to do as well, or of what can go terribly wrong. And many of these countries have experienced things going wrong, and they do need advice with how to avoid mistakes. The second benefit that Romania had was a number of extraordinary people who overall often perform much better than the system. We're speaking not just of individuals, but also institutions, NGOs, lots of them that nobody really knows about throughout the country, but who have been implementing grassroots projects of the utmost importance for somebody who's trying to do micromanagement of transformation and transition processes. And we have a lot of contractual people working in international organizations, but they're not, unfortunately, some of them have not received enough support from the Romanian state. Others have not necessarily sought it. They applied. They are in very high positions now, but that the reputation that they have built does not reflect on the country. Nobody necessarily knows that they come from Romania and that they're exporting an experience which they have gained in Romania. So we're trying now to bring all those people and institutions together in a comprehensive database where we could clearly identify something that pretty much all senior donor countries now know, and that is Romania having this very valuable transition expertise, but very few of them can actually put their finger on it. And very few can say, well, if I'm a large donor country sponsoring a project in Libya, in Tunisia, in Ukraine, and I need expertise in these fields where I can pick these Romanian experts or these Romanian institutions who have worked with it, and these are the results that they have achieved. Well, we're going to have that. It's going to take 1 year. We're doing this with the generous support of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs through official development assistance. We're doing this together with the UNDP and harnessing their expertise and experience in working with Romania. And 1 year from now, we're going to have this database up and running so that we can use it at its maximum potential. And what we're going to be working on very much is to, and this is to address your idea of how to work with authorities without necessarily getting too close to them. Well, we actually like to think that by working with the MFA, we're going to keep pressure on them to convince them that this is actually a political instrument, first of all. It's not just about development, it's a very important political instrument. And the reason is that the first target areas, for instance, for Romania, are those that are very relevant to its foreign policy in general. The European neighborhood, which is suffering very much, and I would agree again with Mrs. Bilchal, from the slowdown in enlargement. And this is very much a way that Romania and other Eastern European countries can complement this fatigue at EU level by serving as examples that it can be done, by serving as examples of how progress can be made even without the political perspective of enlargement necessarily, but on various sectors, and by working together and consolidating ties with these countries. And then there are Middle Eastern countries, North Africa, where again Romania has this amazing benefit of having literally thousands of people speaking Romanian, having lived and studied in Romania, and thus benefits from very high acceptability in those areas. And they're actually, all these partners are looking to Romania for assistance specifically in a number of various sectors, and we haven't been able to deliver to the level that they have been asking. So the entire logic behind our project was, let's create the product first, and then there will be a market, and policy will follow the product. Once it exists, once we have the database and we have a very clear picture of who knows what in Romania, who has done what during these 25 years, this is going to put pressure on authorities to create the policies that can harness the potential of this instrument. And more than that, and I'm again going back to the idea that this is a political instrument, there's been constant interest, and this project has come to life following years of our discussions with foreign embassies in Romania, saying it's such a pity that you don't have something like that, because we would like to work with Romania. We realize that you will not have the large amount of money that will make you a senior donor anytime soon, but you can maximize that because we do have the money and we do have the interest for Romanian experts to be implementing those projects, and we'll be happy to sponsor them as long as you can work with us and as long as we have those experts in place. We're looking at a triangle, Romanian expertise, money from large international donors, and beneficiary countries who are at the same time targets, main targets for Romania's foreign policy. And last but not least, we're also looking at an instrument that's going to boost Romanian cooperation with its regional partners. The Czech Republic, Slovakia, are right now working on a very similar project. So the UNDP is essentially providing the software to all of us and will be building on a similar infrastructure so that these databases at some point in the future hopefully might communicate, might be integrated to a certain extent. I've recently been to Poland. I spoke to them about this project and they said, oh, this is this actually sounds very interesting because we allocate a lot of funds. We're very energetic. We're a very energetic donor, but we don't really measure the impact, and we don't really know how well we're targeting this this aid. So, how about if you share your experience with us, and maybe we can develop something together? And Poland, needless to remind you, is one of Romania's strategic partners and one of its most important partners. We've also received interest from countries in the Black Sea region to expand this project to sort of mapping out the needs of the beneficiary countries and how we can best cooperate with them. So I'm very happy to see that our idea seems to be working, that the market, so to speak, seems to be following the product, and once it's in place, it raises a lot of interest. And I think this is the next step is indeed to continue through occasions like these and others to engage with institutions and raise awareness as to the importance that this instrument can play in the diversification of Romanian foreign policy, in raising the country's profile, and not least in keeping pressure internally to continue with the same reforms, because once they become more visible outside of the country, I think expectations will continue to be raised regarding what happens inside the country. So I think this is of mutual benefit to really everybody involved, and we're looking forward to seeing how this will develop further. Thank you very much, and obviously, just like everybody else, we're waiting for your questions.